You did it. I'm so proud. You built your very first .NET MAUI app, and I've got a couple of resources that will help you advance even further beyond this point, and I've got a very special surprise for you, so stay tuned. So first of all, if you're landing in this video, you know, without following the rest of the course, then check out the playlist on your screen right now or down below in the video description, because this video is part of a full course, actually is the very last video. So in this video, I'm just going to, you know, give you a couple of resources on where you can learn more, how to, you know, go out and be the .NET MAUI developer that you are right now and all those kinds of things. First, I need to thank you, the viewer, for following this course with me. I got so many nice responses while doing this, so thank you so much for that. This is my very first course that I'm putting out there for free on my channel. And there definitely were a couple of learnings. I wanted this course to be free from the beginning, but I also have my membership set up. So what ended up happening, what I didn't really think through, is I was pointing like, hey, you know, I released the first video and I was pointing like, hey, go here for the next video. And then people would come to a video which would say, hey, this is only for members, you need to pay. So that wasn't great because that definitely wasn't my intention. So very sorry, but I did get a couple of new members, so thank you for your faith in me and joining my channel as a member. And of course, a big thank you to James Montemagno, who has done the most work on the workshop that we've been following along on his GitHub repository, and the workshop that you can now also give to other people, because you know how to do it right now and you've learned a ton from that, hopefully. But you know, you can also use that and use that workshop to do it at your company, do it at an event that you might be invited to speak. So definitely use that to your advantage. But James, thank you so much for putting that together. And I had a great time using it throughout my videos. Now, speaking of James, he and his team, I think Matthew Sokoop, who is a advocate at Microsoft, also had a role in this, and the whole Microsoft Learn team, they also already created a Learn module on .NET MAUI. So I will post the link down. There will be a lot of links. All the links will be down below where you can find them. So they already created a .NET MAUI Learn module that you can go to, log in with your Microsoft account, go through another kind of course, learn probably a ton of more stuff that we've seen here, and you will actually get a little bit of experience points that will be credited to your account. So internet points, who doesn't like that? So definitely make sure to check that one out as well. But why stop there? We have this amazing community that's coming over from the Xamarin era, where we've had a couple of resources, namely planetxamarin.com, which is an aggregator that combines all the blog posts, all the other YouTube channels, and maybe some more things from all kinds of authors all around the world. And there is amazing stuff in there. Now, I totally see it still has Xamarin name in there. I'm not sure what's going to happen with that, but a lot of the authors there are already switching to .NET MAUI content as well. So for a long time, Charlin, Xam Girl, you might know her, has been creating a amazing content with her blogs. Her husband, Randy, Xamboy, has been doing the same thing. I think that they're friends with Leo Maris, who has been writing a wonderful blog post as well. Andreas Nesheim, Damien Dahmer, I know he's doing a lot of things. I've seen a blog post by Sebastian Seidel the other day, who helps us with the Google Maps and the Android Maps to create that in your own application, because .NET MAUI GA doesn't have the Maps plugin yet. So we're all helping each other out here. It's a wonderful community. Go check out planetxamarin.com. Maybe something new will come for that with the .NET MAUI name. They also have a Twitter account, so subscribe to that if you are on Twitter, so the feed and the blog post will come to you automatically. But that is an amazing resource for that as well. Now, of course, another amazing resource is the Microsoft Docs. It is, of course, still all being worked on very hard for .NET MAUI GA. There will be a large set. I'm not sure if it will cover 100%, but there will be a lot. But I think there's a great tip in here. It's mostly, you know, everything that you know and love from Xamarin Forms. Now, you might not know about all the history of Xamarin Forms, or you might not have been there to build with Xamarin Forms. It doesn't matter. Whenever you want to figure something out, and you can't find something with .NET MAUI, just search for the same thing in Xamarin Forms. You will probably find some kind of solution, and with a little bit of imagination, you should be able to turn that in a .NET MAUI solution as well. Of course, you know, if you have the time and the means to do that, write a little blog post, make a little content out of it, so that it helps others as well. If you've discovered something, that's always the most amazing thing to do and the wonderful thing about the community. But you know, the docs are there, and if you want to, you can find something, then go to Stack Overflow, go to Google, go to Bing, search for the same thing now with Xamarin or Xamarin Forms, and chances are that you will find your solution that way. And of course, I'm still here and I'm always watching the comments. Well, I try to. There's a lot of comments coming in from the lot of subscribers that I now have, which is really amazing. But please let me know down in the comments if there's something missing, if there's something that you find important, if there's something that you can't figure out. That will help me, you know, create new content. What is top of mind for you? And I will figure out if that's something that I can create videos on and hopefully help more people to get started with NET MAUI that way. And also for that content, it's kind of true. Like, you know, I have a lot of content on Xamarin Forms, so you can still watch those, and that should be easily transferable to NET MAUI as well. But if you feel there's something really outdated, please just add it in a comment right there or send me a note through whatever. I'm on Twitter. I'm on the Discord server that's under all of my videos. So just do that, and I'll see what I can do to make an updated video for that. Now, actually, I want to show you just a tiny little bit still of code, because there was a couple of things that I discovered and I thought of while I was, you know, preparing this last video. So let's quickly hop over back to Visual Studio 2022 and show you a last couple of tips right here. So here, for the very last time, we have the folders here that you've cloned from the repository. Still, the link is in the video description below. And between all the folders, like part 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way through 6, we also have this folder finish. You didn't see that one, right? You didn't cheat, you didn't use the finish folder. But there is a solution as well with the full solution that you can just run, and it has everything in there that we have seen throughout this course. Now, I've opened that one, and one thing that I've thought of is a couple of videos ago, I gave you kind of like the exercise to, you know, make some things specifically whenever you're running on iOS or Android or Windows. And I thought it might be nice to actually show you a little bit of that, because there definitely will be choices whenever you at least go look at like mobile devices and desktop devices. You probably want to tweak some things for these kind of like devices right there. So what I wanted to show you is here, for example, doesn't really matter where we are right here in the code, but here for this background color, you have this app theme binding. You know what that is right now, right? So we got that one. But what you also have here is an extension to do on platform. And with the on platform, you can suddenly say like, hey, I got the platform Android, and you can set a specific value for Android, or you can set for iOS or all the platforms that we're supporting. Android, the iOS, Mac Catalyst, Tizen, UWP, WinUI, even a default one. So that is something that is really cool. Now, converter is also something really cool, which is not specific to on platform. That's typically something that you would use with a binding maybe. So you have the converter right here. And with a converter, which is a value converter, you might know that from other things in the .NET ecosystem. You can provide a value converter that you can use here. You can declare that in your resources, which you now also know how to do. And then you can write your own logic for the background color. If you have, I don't know, an API that gives background colors back with values of 1, 2, 3, 4, and each meaning a specific color, we still have to convert that to this color value for the background color, right? So you can do a binding on the property, which is my color integer. So let's assume that this is a property that is in our view model and has an integer that we need to convert to an actual color. And then we can say converter, and then we have to specify our converter, which has our own logic to convert this integer to the actual color. So we have a lot of converters also in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, which is a project I would highly recommend that you check out. The .NET MAUI Community Toolkit has a lot of these converters and other solutions, even full-blown controls that are out there in the community. We combine them in one package, and you can use that in your application so that you don't have to write and maintain all that stuff yourself. But I was going about on the on platform, so this is just a little sidestep. And you also have on idiom, and with on idiom, you cannot specify like the on platform ones, but you can specify like, hey, am I running on a desktop or a phone or a tablet? So depending on kind of like the form factor, you can specify different values here as well. So this makes it very powerful. You can make combinations. If you're going to do that in XAML, it might not always be like really clear what you're trying to do. It might become very verbose, a lot of lines of code, which is not really great, but it's definitely something that you can do. Of course, you can also do this from code. So let me undo all of this and let me go to a little bit of code code here. Now, I'm not going to actually implement here something. This is just for you as a little tip that you know that it exists. And what you can do here is say if device dot runtime platform is, and then you can say device dot iOS or device dot Android. So that's kind of like the same thing. You can make choices in code with this as well. Do we also have the idiom here? I don't use it with idiom that much, to be honest. Oh, here we are with the idiom. You have it as well, and we have a enum actually that uses it for this. So for the enum, you can for the idiom, you can also make choices depending on the view factor, the form factor that you're looking at. So that's just handy things that you know are out there now. Now, one other thing where I run into is Henry Phoenix. Do we still remember Henry Phoenix? He was annoying me because he was the only monkey that came up when I did the closest to us. And actually, someone in the comments pointed out, so thank you so much for that. Tonis, I think your name was. Sorry if I don't pronounce it correctly or remembered it wrong. But he said, hey, I think this is the bug. So if we go to our monkey details view model, and this is a partial class, so that's why it comes up with multiple results here. We can see here that, oh, this is the open map. Okay, I already lost like my way in the code here. Oh, it was in the main page, right? So view model, monkeys view model, that's where it was. All right, yes. And what we did, we can see here the geolocation, right? So we did this get last known location, and if that's null, we're going to get the actual location, and else we're going to do that get last known location. Now, I'm not sure how this would behave on an actual device, but at least for the emulator, this wasn't great because it would always get this cached location, and that was apparently the one closest to Henry Phoenix. So that is why that bug was happening. If you don't want to do this and you want to see the actual location all the time, just comment out this. It will get the location all the time. It won't go for the cache location, and it will just get the new location all the time, and then should everything work perfectly fine. So that's that bug. Phew, I tied that knot. It's all done. Now you know how to work with that. Of course, there is tons of other stuff to know, but I can't go over all of it. Again, let me know in the comments if there's something that you're missing. Now, last but not least, my big surprise. So I got mine, I got it right here. And it wouldn't be a real course if you wouldn't have any certificate to prove that you went through the course and you actually got it, right? You did the thing, you earned this certificate, and here's mine. I got mine for Gerald Versluis. I've done it. I am now a .NET MAUI expert. And the good news is that you can get your own. You will have to print it yourself. That's definitely something that you need to do. But I've created a generator for you. You can find it in the link here on screen right now or down in the video description below. Go to that website, claim your own certificate. And of course, if you want more people to learn about .NET MAUI and maybe, you know, support me a little bit with this course, make sure to share it on all your socials, tag me in it, do whatever. I would really love to see that because it was just a little fun idea that I would, I thought it would be fun to close this course with. So again, and thank you so much for following this course with me, being on this journey with me. I really appreciate any and all of you. So thank you so much for that. If you've been following along and you've actually built your first app, now I don't recommend that each and every one of you will release a Monkey Finder app to the store. But if you've built your own app, I've got a playlist that will help you publish your iOS app, Android app, and Windows app to the store. You can actually even sideload your Windows app. So that is pretty amazing. The playlist for that you can find here. And I've got all kinds of other .NET MAUI videos already up here as well. You can find the playlist for that here. And if you really haven't subscribed yet now, what are you even doing? Please do that through the button right here. And I'll see you for the next course or video. I'll see you for the next one.